लेट लूज योर होल बॉडी, हेड ऑफ चिन मुद्रा बोथ हैंड्स, रिलैक्स योर फेशियल मसल्स. Let's start the session with chanting of three Omkaras. Take a deep breath in. Last day. Join your thoughts for prayer. Sit forearm should be corner to the floor. Thumb should be touching the sternum, middle of your chest. सहनावतु सहनौभुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शांति शांति. ठीक है करें. ड्रॉप योर शोल्डर्स एंड पोज. शशांक प्रणाम. नेक्स्ट टू शशांक ब्रीथिंग. Straighten your vajrasana, hold your wrist, open your shoulder, inhale, exhale, bend down. Finally, drop your shoulder, inhale, slowly come up, open your chest, inhale. Then exhale, push your chin forward, drop your head. Shashank breathing, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Last time, inhale, exhale. Slowly come up. Now, standing breathing practice, join your palms. Inhale, push your chest forward, expand your rib cage, fill up your hands, exhale, head shoulder level. Inhale, push your chest forward, exhale. Synchronize your hand movement with your breathing. Inhaling, push your arms back. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. प्लस टेन इंटू एट As usual, using practices, forward backward trading. Inhale. Swing your hands. Bend back. Do not bend at your elbows. Exhale. Inhale. Forward, backward, bending. Very good for your spine. Do not force your limbs. Do as much as you can. Follow the technique. Last time. Side bending. Foot should be parallel. Bend sideways. You can just exhale. So now bending, twisting, come back, inhale, come up, exhale, bend, twist, inhale, come up, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale up, exhale, bend, twist, come back. Inhale, come up, exhale. Bend, twist, come back, come up, bend, twist, come back, come up. Last time. You know, alternate toe touching. Concentrate on your waist, twist it properly. Look up each time. So you come up, no? Bring your legs a little bit near. Twist. Concentrate on your waist. Hand shoulder level. Was it twist? Knees one side, hands other side. Stop the practice. Just relax for a while. Shithila Tadasana. So next, let's do jogging, fist form on your chest, start with slow jogging, open your mouth, now lift up, slow jogging, back, and this will be better. Slow jogging, sideways, fist palm on your chest, don't move your hands. Again, slow jogging. Finally, swing. Exhale from your mouth. Mukha Dhoti. Throwing out excess heat produced in your body. Forceful exhalation from your mouth. Now, sit and relax. Do not collapse your back. Let loose your body. You can close your eyes and observe your breathing so that you can relax faster. Before starting the yoga practices, you have to stimulate your body first by loosening practices and dynamic practices. Loosening practices are forward backward bending, side bending, bending in twisting, full twist and opposite twist. Then dynamic practices are jogging, jumping, mountain climbing, sit-ups. Anyone you can choose, which you can do properly, and then it has to raise your heartbeat, should be cardiovascular effect. Then you have to sit and relax before starting any asanas. Let's start the sitting postures now. Start with Bharatrajasana. For that, join your legs. This is kriti. Attention in sitting posture. Before starting any sitting asana, you have to come to this posture first. So now, both legs towards your right, like this. One foot on the other, anchor on the other foot, then turn, if you can, try to catch your big toe, look back, twisting of your waist is very important here. Heart twisting postures are very good for the people who are having diabetes. Turn more, both hands should be straight. Bharatrajasana, remember the names of the practices. Okay, turn back. And then release your legs one by one. See, in between two practices, you need to relax at least for 15 to 30 seconds so that you can practice the next asana properly with full of energy. So now let's do the same to the opposite side. Both legs towards your left, then you have to turn right. Now try to catch your toe. Turn back, both shoulders should come in one line. Both knees should be rested on the floor. Remember, both knees on the floor, both hands straight. This hand should be below your knee. Hit back your right shoulder. Hit back. Do not lean on your back hand. Raise your back. Twist your waist. Gently release the posture, release your leg, relax. So next we are going to practice one forward bending, that is Malasana. For that, join your foot and then join your heels. Come up on your foot. Go lift your heels. If your heels are lifting, you can separate your foot. See now, like this, you have to catch your heels and then bend down. If possible, try to put your chin on the floor. Malasana or garland posture. Your hands are surrounded to your knees like a garland. It looks like a garland. Stay there. If you are comfortable, breathe normally. Inhaling. Slowly come up. Sit back, release your legs, relax again, Malasana, garland posture. Next we are going to do Akarna, Dhanurasana. For that, again, join your foot, clasp your fingers in your toes, then inhale, lift up, exhale down, inhale, lift up, leg should be straight. Now, Karna, Dhanurasana, again, inhale. Lift up, exhale, inhale, exhale. This is we are practicing as a breathing practice. This is inhale, exhale. Last time, inhale, exhale. Now let's do it as asana. Let's maintain for a little longer time. Hold it. Stay there. Do not collapse your back. Release. With the leg. Look front. Karuna. Dhanurasana. It looks like a bow and arrow action. Slowly release. Relax for a while. While relaxing, we feel the effect of the asana. You can feel the very good twist, bending, stretching. Now let's do a variation. Just to change your hands. Catch the upper toe and then lift up. Akarna, Anurasana variation. Now, other side. Release. This is just for practice. It gives a twisting effect to the asana. Relax again until your breathing comes to normal. Feel the changes in your body. You can feel the very good stretch in your arms. And then it expands your pelvic region also. Note the benefits also. It works on your lower abdomen. Remember, spine should not be collapsed, back should be straight. Next, we are going to do one balancing asana, that is Vatayanasana. For that, one leg, Dantra Padmasana, then stand up. On your knee, stand straight, then see one knee and then one foot. You have to balance on that and then back should be straight. Lift up your hands, lift up. It's a very good balancing practice, Vatayanasana. Slowly release. So now, as you enter the asana, just release your knee first, and then other leg, then the first leg. Now to release right leg. Vatayanasana, very powerful balancing posture. Now, let's practice the same with the other leg. Left leg Ardha Padmasana. So knee should go down. That is very important. Whenever you are doing Ardha Padmasana, your knee should not be lifted. Now to just press it down. And then your leg should come up. Otherwise it may slip down. Like this. And then just put those two palms. Then like this. Stand up, then again, change your hands, Vatayanasana, lift your hands up, back straight, you can just see the posture, one foot, and then one knee, knee should be back, and then right foot should be front. Slowly release. As we went to the asana, you have to relax the legs one by one. First, put your hands by the side of your knee and then release this leg. Then release your right leg. Then release your left foot. Relax. Each and every asana has its own merits and then effect on your body. Changes your body internally, it balances all the activities of your body. Because of time constraint, we are not holding for longer than. Otherwise, you should try to hold the position for longer than, as much as it is comfortable for you. Now let's come to standing posture. Let's practice few standing asanas. First, relax your knees. You have dipped the knee. You have put pressure on your waist. You have to relax them properly. Relax both sides. Now we are going to do Trikonasana, triangular posture. For that, separate your legs, stretch your head sideways. See how to separate as much as you can. It should be parallel, center point. Then turn your right foot up, left foot in, left hand on your waist, not front, should be back. Hit back your shoulder, left shoulder. Then adjust your feet. You have to separate as much as you can. Then not stretch. Stretch like that, someone is pulling your hand. Stretch. If you can't stretch more, just bring that hand down. Toss your chest. Raise your hand up. Bend now. Trikonasana. It is a lateral bending practice. Bend down. Adjust your feet every time. Bend, bend. You have to get very good stretch in your inner thigh. Bend down. Look up the ceiling. Look at your palm. Do not bend forward. Trikonasana. Triangular posture. Both knees should not be bent. Both legs should be straight. Both hands should be straight. Follow the technique properly. See, when you are in the final posture, you have to breathe properly. Now inhaling, slowly come up with the stretch. Turn your far foot. Then bring your legs here. Then relax back in Shithila Tadasana. Standing relaxing practice. Feel the effect of the asana. Now let's practice other side. Again, separate your legs as much as you can. Stretch your head sideways. Now, right hand on your waist. Should not be like this, it should go back. Remember, both shoulders should be in one leg. Then just put left foot out, right foot in, and then hand shoulder level. Don't take it down, shoulder level. Now stretch fast, stretch, stretch, stretch. Maximum stretching should be there. If you can't stretch further, just bring that hand down. Toss your chest. This is very important. Toss your chest. Raise your head up. Now bend. Adjust your feet. Bend. Bend. Do not bend forward. You need not put your hand on the floor. If you are perfectly flexible, you can put your hand down without bending forward. Use very good stretch, otherwise just keep your fingers on the shin bone. Look up the ceiling. Look at your head palm. Both legs should be straight. Please do not bend it in the knee. If you bend it, you will not get the stretch or effect of the asana. Try to maintain for long time. Now, come back with the stretch, turn your foot, bring them here, load it with your hand, relax back in, Shithila Tadasana. Next, let's practice Natarajasana. Lift your leg up. The shirt tie should come parallel to the floor. Lift the other hand. So balancing is very important. Lift up. Look at a particular point. Straight up. No need to bend. This is a back bending and balancing. Slowly release. So if you bend forward, that bending effect will not be there. Back bending effect. Then let's practice with the other leg. Catch your ankle from inside. Stretch up. So if you bend forward, you will not get that stretch. Now to straighten your hands. Lift your thigh up as much as you can. Stretch up. You get the constriction in your lower back. And then both thigh and hand will be stretched properly. Slowly release your hand. Release your leg. You can feel the back bending effect. Now again, relax your knees. If you feel exertion in your lower back, you can relax your waist clockwise and anti-clockwise rotation. Then next we are going to practice Surya Namaskara. We are done with the asanas, sitting and standing asanas. Now join your palms. जन्मेन पात्रेण सत्यस्यापि हितं मुखं तत्त्वं भूषं अपाकृणो सत्यधर्माय दृष्टये ॐ ह्रां Uttanasana. Toes and fingers in one way. Make a path of the Saranasana. Should be vertical to the floor. Try to put your palm down. Push your waist down. Look front. Just to concentrate on your Ajna Chakra in between your eyebrows. Make a path of the Saranasana. Now, Vipada Prasaranasana, head to heel one way, look little bit front. Shashankasana, put your knees down, release your toes, sit back. Elbows down, forehead down, buttocks down. Come up with inhalation. Ashtanga Namaskara Asana. You can either put your forehead or chin on the floor. Draw elbows near your body. Then Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Lift your knees up. Push your waist down. Open your shoulders. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Stamp your knees. And again, Shashankasana. Next is, bring back your leg, Ashwasanchalanasana. Look at this, it should be perpendicular to the floor. Look front, Ashwasanchalanasana. Horse, get ready to go. Urani. Padamastasana. Then back to Namaskara Mudra. Om Hrim Namah. चत्वारी पंच शत सप्त अष्ट अष्ट नव दश एकादश द्वादश ॐ सूर्याय नमः. लेट्स फॉलो ब्रीथिंग नाउ. इनहेल एक्सहेल इनहेल फिर के बाद Inhale, knees strong. Release your toes. Exhale, sit back on your knees. Shushantasana. Inhale, come up. Point your toes. Exhale. Ashtanga Namaskarasana. Hit your chest, chin, one forehead, two palms, two knees, two toes. उत्तम कुशवासना अधोम कुशवासना शशांक आसना इनहे अश्वसंजन आसना एक्सिट नमस्कार मुद्रा ओम मानवे नमः ऊर्ध्वासन उत्तानासन एक पाद प्रसन्न विश्व विपाद प्रसन्न और दंडासन शशाकासन अष्टांग नमस्कार आसन ऊर्ध्वमुख श्वानासन अधोमुख श्वानासन शशांकासन अश्वसंचलनासन पादहस्तासन नमस्कार मुद्रा ओम ह्रीं खगाय नमः एकम द्वे त्रीणि चत्वारि पंच षट सप्त अष्ट नव दश एकादश द्वादश ॐ ब्रीद इन ब्रीद आउट ब्रीद इन ब्रीद आउट ब्रीद इन ईच डाउन ब्रीद आउट शीर्षांकन से मूव ब्रीद इन ब्रीद आउट 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 ॐ नमः हिरण्यगर्भाय नमः ऊर्ध्वासन उत्तानासन एकपादप्रसरणासन द्विपादप्रसरणासन शशांकासन अष्टांग नमस्कार आसन ऊर्ध्व मुख श्वानासन अधो मुख श्वानासन शशांकासन अश्व संचलन आसन एक पुट्टी और पाव स्टॉप फुली If possible, Padma Prasthasana, Namaskar Mudra, Om Hrim Marijane Namaha, One, Two, Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. षटक सप्तक अष्टक नवम दश एकादश द्वादश पुष्प संचलन आसन ओम भास्कर ऊर्ध्वासन उत्तानासन एकपाद प्रसरणासन द्विपाद प्रसरणासन शशांकासन अष्टांग नमस्कार आसन ऊर्ध्व मुख श्वानासन उभमुख श्वानासन शशांकासन अश्वसंचलनासन पादहस्तासन नमस्कार मुद्रा लास्ट राउंड ऑफ सूर्य नमस्कार दैट इज बीज मुद्रा यू कैन जस्ट फॉलो और रिपीट आफ्टर मी ओम श्री सवित्र सूर्य नारायण ओम ट्राई टू वर्क विद बीज आसना Try to join your lower palms and go straight. Drop your hip. Do not bend at your knee. Om Hrim Ramahe Namah. Toes and fingers to align. If possible, try to touch up for the head to the knee. ॐ ॐ सूर्याय नमः कॉन्सेंट्रेट इन बिटवीन योर एयरब्रोस ॐ ह्रीं भानवे नमः स्ट्रेटन योर एयरब्रोस हेड टू हील वन टाइम लुक फ्रंट Just concentrate on your navel or Manipura chakra. Om Ram Padaya Namah. Very relaxing practice. Shushanthasana. Let me come up. Om Ram. Do not rest your abdomen. Gain grip posture. Ashtanga Namaskarasana. ॐ राम हिरण्यगर्भाय नमः। ॐ ह्रीं मणिजने नमः। बॉडी शुड कम इन कैपिटल लेटर्स। ॐ ह्रूं आदित्याय नमः। ॐ ह्रीं सवित्रे नमः। थैंक यू फॉर योर पाल्म्स टॉप। ॐ ह्रौं अर्काय नमः। थैंक यू फादर स्तंभ। ॐ ह्रौं भास्कराय नमः। हियर इज द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ सूर्य नमस्कार। 12+1 13 राउंड्स। सूर्य नमस्कार इज अ फुल फ्लेज्ड प्रैक्टिस डेली। इफ यू डू एटलीस्ट 3 to 4 राउंड्स लर्न बाय लर्निंग द टेक्निक प्रॉपरली इट विल बी अ परफेक्ट asana practice for you. Before that, loosening is advised and after that, shavasana and then pranayama also very important. Those who do not remember any asanas, just do loosening, dynamic practice, pranayama of Surya Namaskara and then shavasana and then pranayama. It takes at least half an hour or 40 minutes. Don't skip any practices. Try to practice regularly. It's my humble request. So now, let's relax in Makarasana. Let's practice few asanas in prone posture. Separate your legs. Chin on the cross to point out your forearm. Very relaxing practice. It's very good for the people who are having hypertension. In a good posture to relax your mind. Today let's practice one more variation of Bhujangasana. Join your legs, stretch your legs forward, chin on the floor. Both palms by the side of your lower lip. Draw elbows near your body. Inhale, push your waist down, knees on the floor. Open your foot, arch your back, look up. Urdhva Bhujangasana. Push your waist down. Separate posture, Bhujangasana, exhaling, keep your down your body, exhaling, just come up, straighten your elbows, main thing is you have to push your legs down, open your shoulders, look up, it's very good for the people. For having back pain, then self good for the people who are having thyroid problem. Again, bring down your body very gently with exhalation. Now we are going to practice Tiryak Bhujangasana. Inhaling, come up, shut this down, turn towards your right, look at your heels. Twisted, serpent posture, turn back, exhale down, should be controlled movement, please do not drop your body anytime. Okay, anyone is having exertion in your back, you can just separate your legs. Stand towards your left, look at your heels. Turn back, exhaling, bring your body down. This is the practice of one more variation of Bhujangasana. Again, rest back in Makarasana. This is relaxing crocodile. Now, let's do the complementary posture for your legs. Now, just try to catch your chin, then flap your knees. Rest on the buttocks. It's very good for your knees also. It's very good for your back. Very gently release your hands. You can just practice like this also. This is more relaxing than the earlier one. Now, separate your legs, relax. As usual, our next practice is plank. Come on, head to heel, one leg. We come. द्वे, त्रीणि, चत्वारि, पञ्च, षट्, सप्त, अष्ट, नव, दश, साइड प्लैंक, एकादश, द्वादश, त्रयोदश, चतुर्दश, पञ्चदश, षोडश, सप्तदश, अष्टादश, नवदश, विंशतिः. अदर साइड. एकम, द्वे, त्रीणि, चत्वारि, पञ्च, षट्, सप्त, अष्ट, नव, दश. तो फाइनली वन मोर राउंड ऑफ मंगल प्लैंक. दश, नव, अष्ट, सप्त, षट्, पञ्च, चत्वारि, त्रीणि, द्वे, एकम. नाउ इमीडिएटली turn on your back and relax. Supine posture. Let loose your body. Just observe each and every part of your body. More than that, please concentrate on your breathing. It brings back your breathing rate to normal. Yoga is stimulating, maintaining, and relaxing. By connecting mind and body. With breathing, connect your mind, body, and breath properly. You are practicing with awareness, with complete dedication. Today we are going to do Avalokitasana Kriya. Join your legs, stretch your hands up along the floor. Swing in, lift your right leg up straight 90 degree, then fold it. Those who are not having neck pain or hypertension or high BP, they can lift your head their property, change to the moon, then rotate the other way. One, try to make a bigger round. Two, three. If your head is or neck is exerting, can release, otherwise, hold it. Five, six, see, inhale up, exhale down, seven, inhale up, exhale down, eight, nine, ten, now rest your leg, rest your head down. Now again, lift up, reverse rotation, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Inhale up, exhale, inhale, exhale, release your leg. Now you can release your leg also. Relax your body. There is again exhilaration in your breathing rate. Just relax. Again, join your legs, stretch your hands up along the floor, lift your left leg straight, 90 degree, hold it, lift your head up, rotate your right leg. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, control movement, try to make a bigger round, inhale up, exhale, last time, inhale. Release your head, hold your knee, relax. Now again lift your head up, chin to the knee, reverse, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Hold it. Release your leg. Stretch up your left leg, release that also. Relax, back in, supine posture. This is a very good practice. Get to get rid of excessive air in your stomach. Muttasana, releasing air. Very helpful for digestion. They're very good for your hip joint. Pavana Muktasana Kriya. Now you can just do a alternate leg raising. 1, 2, spread your elbows. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Do not touch your knees to the floor. Do as much as you can. Stop the crunches. Join your knees. Separate your foot. Relax. Next is side crunches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop it like that. See, join your knees, separate your toes, palms by the side of your body. Now let's practice relaxation. It is again one more variation of folded leg lumbar stretch. Both knees towards your right. One knee should touch the other feet. Look left. Do not lift your upper arm. Inhale, knees up. Exhale. Knees towards your left. Look right. Inhale, knees up. Exhale. You can get a little stretching in your lumbar region. Look opposite side. Inhale up. Join your knees. Exhale. Knees towards your left. Look right. Palms down. Palms should be pressing the floor. Inhale, knees up. Exhale. Last time, inhale, knees up. Exhale. Only. Bring your knees up, stretch your legs forward, relaxing, shavasana. Then close your whole body, close your eyes. Better to relax on the same surface. Just observe your abdominal for the moment. How they are bulging up and sinking down. Just observe your abdominal muscle movement for 5 rounds. So now, correct your breathing. When your abdomen is bulging up, now to inhale. When it is sinking down, now to exhale. Now your breathing is normal. You can practice 5 rounds of deep breathing, deep inhalation. That is yogi breathing in supine posture. Slow exhalation. Let your fingers pick up. Exhalation should be twice the time of a inhalation. So now take a deep breath in, chant one akara. Chant one akara. So now gently move your toes, fingers, and leg. Bring your legs together, hands near the body. Fold your left leg, slide your right hand above, turn the hips to the right. Put one leg on the other, take one more breath, feel the ingredients awareness. So, with both palms support, go to the bottom, Shavasana. You are completely relaxed now. The breathing is normal, body is completely relaxed, mind is also relaxing. Next, we'll have a 10 to 15 minutes of pranayama session and then omkara and then ending prayer. Sit in any comfortable posture of your choice or then you can sit back to the wall also to rest your back. You can sit in Sukhasana, just and sitting like this, cross leg posture, and then Padmasana if you are comfortable, or Vajrasana, or Virasana, or Siddhasana, anyone you can choose. But if you want to change the posture, you can change in between two practices, not in between, in the middle of the practice. But please do not sit with pain or numbness. Let's start the pranayama session. Sitting in Padmasana automatically makes your back erect. You can't collapse your back here. Now, let's start pranayama shloka. प्राणसेदं वशेत् सर्वं त्रिदिवे यत्प्रतिष्ठितं मातेव पुत्रां रक्षस्व श्रीश्च प्रज्ञांश्च विदेहिनैति. Let's start with 60 counts of Kapalabhati. That is practice of 1 minute. Moderate speed is 1 stroke per second, forceful exhalation from both the nostrils at the same time, sucking your abdominal muscles. Forcefully. Stop the practice. Just experience the calmness of your mind. Kevala Kumbhaka. For temporary cessation of breath. Once you feel like resuming the breathing, you just adopt Brahma Mudra. Put it beside your navel region and then relax your shoulders and elbows. Relax the face, relax the body, relax mind. Deep inhalation, slow exhalation, during pranayama practice, if you feel like closing your eyes, you can definitely close your eyes. But listen to the instructions and follow technique properly. Now we are going to practice Anuloma Viloma Pranayama or alternate nostril breathing, which is popularly known as Nadi Shodhana Pranayama or Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama. For that, left hand Chin Mudra, right hand Nasika Mudra. Hold these two fingers. Close your right nostril with the thumb. Start with exhalation from the left. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale from the left, exhale from the right, inhale from the right, exhale from the left, inhale from the left. Exhale from the right. Inhale from the right. Exhale from the left. Continue for two more rounds. Two inhalations and two exhalations together is one round. Our pranayama practices should be as slow as possible. Apana Bhatiya Bhastrika Kriyas, the preparatory practice for pranayama. Let use your body and do the practice. Master. Stop the practice with exhalation. Now, Brahmani. inhalation and exhalation through nostrils only. While exhaling, touch your tongue to the upper palate and then produce humming B sound. This is a nasal sound. Just try to vibrate the nakara. Nakara popularly said to be. Again. Close your earlobes with your tongue, nostrils slightly with your little finger, and then other three fingers press to your pocket. Inhale. Again. First sitting, meditative posture. In silence, inhale mudra. Listen to the shloka from Bhagavad Gita. Khyayate vishayan posaha sangaste shupajayate sangat sanjayate kamaha kamat krodho vijayate krodha bhavati sammoha Samoha Smriti Vibhrama Smriti Pravcha Buddhi Nasha Buddhi Nasha Nasha. How a person deteriorates and then completely vanishes, or destructions of a person is said to be in this shloka. Jayate Vishaya Posa. Whenever a person thinks of in the connectivity of a material thing. Vishaya is material thing. Posa, any person, sangasteshu pajaya, he will be attached to that thing. Sangat sanjayate kama, whenever he thinks of getting it, he feels that craving, that is sangat sanjayate kama. Kama krodho vijaya, if he is not getting it, and then you get angry or annoyed. Krodha bhavati sammoha. His anger, he develops attachment, more attachment to that material thing. Or angriness also increases. Sammoha bhavati smriti vibhrama. And then he will be always thinking of the same thing. He is restless until he gets it. Samoha smriti pravcha, smriti pravcha vinashyati. With that restless mind, and then agitation, and then bowl of desire, that person completely vanishes. So, before getting attached to the material thing, at the first step itself, you have to avoid that thought. That's how it is explained. Dhyayate vishayan pulsa sangasteshu pajayate sangha sanjayate kama kama krodho vijayate krodha bhavati sammoha सम्मोहात् स्मृति विद्रोह स्मृति प्रवचा बुद्धि नाश बुद्धि नाश इति कृतले डिस्ट्रॉयड सिनो कंप्लीटली एट द डोर ऑफ द पीस ट्रैंक्विलिटी those who are having more time can continue with the meditation. Others can play with this session with me, chanting Om Omkara, take a deep breath in. Let's end the session with a prayer. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukha bhag bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Take back your hands. Inhale, bend back. Exhale, bend forward. Yoga Mudra. Drop your shoulders, elbows. Inhale. Come up gently, rub your palms, transfer that produce relief to your eyeballs, do not press them. Here is our session for today. Thank you everyone.